This week, our team of monster builders get medieval as they take on transforming this run-of-the-mill domicile into a castle fit for a king and queen. The homeowners have agreed to turn their humble abode over to the Merlin of Monster Makeovers, Steve Watson. Known far and wide as a builder bold and brazen, Steve and his crew will have to complete this considerable challenge in only 5 days.
That's Monster House, baby.
Our house was plain and simple. It was safe and normal. It was nice and sweet. But we all agreed we could use a change. And then something happened that was very strange. Cause a van showed up, all our stuff went flying. And my mom was crying till the job was done. Now it's a monster house. It's a monster house. It's a monster house. And we all just love it. It's a monster house.
Sid and Roya, newlyweds with a new home that isn't living up to the old saying.
A man's home is his castle.
We both love English castles, actually. My husband Sid's from England.
I sort of want the house to go from a bland house on our street to a castle on the top of the hill, which is rightly where it should be.
They've summoned the Robin Hood of radical remodels, Steve Watson.
Hey. How's it going, Sid?
Hey, Steve.
Yeah, how are you?
All design and construction decisions will be up to Steve and his noble team. Sid and Roya won't be privy to the proceedings. They'll be spending the week in a motorhome parked out front. Steve summons his designers to the Royal Roundtable. Architect Todd Erlinson, illustrator Craig Rizzo, and medieval design expert Chance Hawes.
Sid is from England, you know. He's a little homesick. He would like to have some English flair in his home. So we turned their normal suburban tract home into a medieval castle.
Castle.
You cannot have a castle without a drawbridge. I'm thinking that we give them a breakfast table and a dining room table, and that's their drawbridge, dinner table, and some sort of a chain mechanism into the breakfast area. And then, of course, you've got the one that comes out to the dining room area. And so you've got the drawbridge action. Now let's get into the family area. The hearth in the medieval times was a gathering point for the family. That's where the family would gather around a big fire.
Or the media center,
well,
right?
The media center is the biggest thing in a house today anyway. Right?
Big, monster, huge, massive hearth that's gonna consume the entire room. This hearth needs to look like it's out of stone. This needs to be gothic and medieval and huge. But how do we do this without bringing in 5 tons of rock?
Foam. We'll do that at carved foam. Hard-coated, it's all fire protected. It'll look just like it.
They have sliding glass doors, and they've got some screens that have just been ripped all to pieces.
Those gotta go.
So what if right there we get rid of the sliding glass doors? Because I don't believe they had sliding glass doors in the medieval era.
Probably not.
We'd have to have what about huge Dutch barn doors?
Yeah.
I was talking to Sid and Roy a little bit, but I think they might be a little freaky. You know what I'm saying? What if just as an extra added bonus, we give them a bed of nails coffee table? Yeah, throw some old handcuffs on there or something, you know?
Here's the plan. For the kitchen and dining room, a double-sided drawbridge table. For the living room, a stone hearth that will turn into a home entertainment center. The sliding glass rear entry will become Dutch barn doors. The finishing touch, medieval furniture, including wooden benches and a bed of nails coffee table.
They better feel like they're the king and queen of their neighborhood.
Day one.
Hear ye, hear ye. The current master and the mistress of the house will now present themselves.
Sid and Roya come face to face with this week's 5 brave builders. Smiley Barnacle, master of metal and prince of pompadours. Kurt Schaefer, furniture maker extraordinaire. John Granis, general contractor and licensed electrician. Joshua Smith, apprentice carpenter. And continuing from the design team, medieval times set builder Chance Hawes. If these noble knights can finish the job by midnight Friday, they'll each receive a tool package from Makita and Esab worth $3,000.
Listen well, for you are now provisionally banished from your domicile to the lonely land of the South Wind Storm.
But one thing's still missing.
get medieval on this place.
Yes, sir.
Let's get to work.
Steve leads the team inside to reveal this week's battle plan.
This is one of the walls we're going to be concentrating on this week. This is their formal dining area. It's a drawbridge-style table, pulley system in the ceiling on a chain.
So this is the first wall.
Right there.
Right there.
Thank you.
What's next?
Same thing, this side. Drawbridge table, couple of benches, same mechanism.
Boom. It starts with a hole, right? That should line up with the other one.
Steve might have reason to be a little scared of this hammerhead.
I'm about to take the hammer away from John because I think he's a maniac. Out there. Yeah. All right, this is the medieval hearth. This is not going to be a functioning fireplace. This is going to be their entertainment center. This wheel is going to work a mechanism that's going to drop their television into the firebox. Okay, this has to go. No, you need to put your hammer away. We've got some Spanish cedar for you. You're gonna build some barn doors. One thing you guys have to remember is that we're in someone's house. These people have got to live here. So everything has to be functional, it has to work, has to be done perfect. Your craftsmanship has to be stellar. And it has to be done by Friday night at midnight. That is the challenge.
Before the games can begin, the playing field needs to be cleared.
Excellent, thank you. Set.
In the kitchen, they start by sawing a hole in the wall for the drawbridge table.
Just the drywall, don't worry about the stud.
Surprise!
Yeah, we found a nice little junction box up there.
There turns out to be a tangle of wiring in the way. And somebody got a little carried away with the power saw.
You got a snag there?
Make the little flex.
It just gives you one more thing to fix, man. That's all right.
John is more than up for the challenge. An expert electrician and carpenter, he's the most experienced member of this week's crew.
Here's Johnny.
I had my contractor's license when I was 21 years old. I've got to get my hands on everything. Steel, cement, framing, drywall, insulation, laminates, and corian, and carpentry, electrical, bricks, and blocks. My experience here will probably come in handy troubleshooting.
To make way for the barn doors, the sliding glass has got to go. The job of ripping out the door frame goes to Joshua, the least experienced member of the team. Already, he seems to be struggling.
I'm a young pup in this situation. I'm a hard worker, and that's what I have to offer. You only need one chief. You got too many chiefs around the tribe. It ain't gonna work.
Let's just knock it out.
I'm thinking.
Knock it out.
Tearing out this door frame turns out to be tougher than it looks.
I don't know what's holding this frame in here. All the screws are out. This is some kind of magic pain in the ass is what it is.
Steve lets this tenderfoot in on a bit of monster wisdom. If it don't move, use a bigger hammer.
Are you kidding me? What the hell is this thing? Good job, Joshua.
It's not exactly a fire-breathing dragon, but our proud knights haul off their first conquest.
Get that thing out of here.
Never seen anything like that before. Definitely work out, man.
The team turns their attention to the living room's not very medieval-looking carpet.
This carpet reminds me of a tux I wore at my eighth grade prom, so it's gotta go.
It already looks better without blue carpet.
Beautiful.
It's almost lunch. The demolition is done and the living room's a blank canvas. Out front, the team gathers to divvy up the duties.
We know we have three major projects. Okay, who are the carpenters here?
We're all carpenters. Okay.
Carpenter Kurt agrees to take on building the barn doors. Chance, the set designer, will oversee making a stone hearth out of foam. John will do the framing and wiring work. And the toughest job goes to the master of metal, Smiley Barnacle. It will be up to him to design and build the hoist mechanisms for the drawbridge table and TV lift. Smiley's already had his first brainstorm. Put the TV in a birdcage.
Kind of the design I was thinking about, sort of a wrought iron birdcage that
that goes up and down,
right,
with a TV in it, right? So it looks like a dumbwaiter of some sort, you know?
That's good too. That'll look really nice hanging down below too as a finished piece. Like
it's already mid-afternoon. Time to start building. While John finishes clearing the hole for the drawbridge tables, Chance, Josh, and Kurt start framing out the hearth.
It's kind of terrifying. It seems like everybody really knows what they're doing here.
Before Smiley can begin building his birdcage, he needs metal. He makes a shopping list and heads off for the metal store, driving one of his own creations.
This is Ernie Warhol. It was actually named by my grandmother. She's like, you know, that thing's really beautiful. It's like a work of art. It's like that guy, Ernie. I'm like, Ernie who? You know, that guy, Warhol, Ernie Warhol, right? That's his name. I'm like, yeah, Ernie Warhol. 100% street legal. That there, that's a hood ornament. And that there, that's a roof rack. But then we turned into a dragon. You can't have a castle without a dragon. So I brought my dragon.
At Industrial Metal Supply, Smiley has a field day fleshing out his TV birdcage.
Trying to make this kind of cage. So we want to come up with this kind of blacksmith detail. So maybe some stuff on the sides and maybe a little bit on top, just to sort of dress it up.
Let's put this on the bottom. That would be cool.
Back at the house, the rest of the team is feeling that this castle's going to be a piece of cake.
I think that tomorrow, before we leave, that we can have all of our major things built. I think that
absolutely have it all built. The only thing we'll be working on is the mechanics of it all, making it all work.
I think all the construction could be done tomorrow.
Cool.
So I think that's pretty much the plan.
Though the framing work has barely begun, the crew decides to call it quits and head home early. Out front, a passing neighbor is impressed.
Wow. No, my goodness. A castle.
And so is her dog.
Would you like to poo on Monster House? Christen the castle.
Day two, and our well-rested team arrives at the crack of dawn. Smiley shows up in another of his creations. Homeowner Sid awakes from his first night in the motorhome and can't resist picking through the entrails of his living room.
Good job on the blue.
Very happy with that. Keep it up.
So I'm sort of piecing together what I remember from the house. The blue carpet's out, I'm ecstatic about that. And I think I recognize a bit of the sliding door. I'm not worried from what I see, because it's things that I would have liked to have seen gone anyway. So that's a good thing.
Smiley and Kurt have come up with a way to bring the TV birdcage into the 21st century.
With a ceiling lift assembly here, what it's designed to do is lift the TV up and hide it, which is exactly what we're trying to do. However, it's electric, so we're trying to get the okay to go with something other than a purely
mechanical manual
means, yeah.
No, we're gonna keep that manual.
No! So what you're telling us is you're not gonna allow us to build the state-of-the-art castle.
What we're doing is we're applying the medieval theme to their existing lifestyle, and that's the situation.
We're counting on you, Smiley. You gotta make it move. Yeah. I'm gonna get it all built in a day or two, then I'm yours.
You'll be built by
Let's get back to work.
Good job, guys.
Thank you.
Pop, there we go.
Smiley now needs to figure out how to make tables and TVs move using just pulleys, chains, and winches.
I went to art school. I'm not an engineer. But, you know, neither was Leonardo, right? Of course, he never even went to art school.
That's what we're doing. See that?
Inside, Chance finishes the frame for the hearth.
The pressure is on. The pressure is on.
The basic skeleton is done in no time.
The TV's actually going to go in the center here, up under here. And then there's going to be the wheel here, which you're going to be able to spin, and then it's going to drop the TV down to about here.
Chance moves on to building a pair of plank doors for the laundry closet.
We've got some nice oak face on a 3/4-inch plywood, nice sturdy doors.
To hold the doors, Steve fashions a set of medieval hinges.
Right now I'm getting these hinges for all of our doors and everything ready, and we're just going to grind them down and make them look like they belong in a castle. This Makita grinder, that is a bitchin' hardcore monster grinder right there. This thing is just bad. It's one of my favorite tools.
Across the yard, Master Kurt shows apprentice Josh a secret for making invisible joints. He's inserted round wooden discs called biscuits between the Spanish cedar planks. Add some everyday wood glue and join the pieces together. After an hour in the clamps, they have a drawbridge table. It's not your typical piece of furniture, but then again, Kurt is not your typical carpenter.
I've been in California for about 15 years. I moved out here to be a rock and roll star, and as you can tell, I work in construction.
In the kitchen, John has framed the hole for the tables, but he still needs to reroute and repair the nicked wiring.
I'm just gonna inspect for any damaged, nicked wires that could cause a short, you know, possibly cause the house to burn down. You can see where he cut one wire through completely. And somebody turned that power back on.
Oh!
It felt like the whole city power just came right through my body.
After spending all morning scratching his head, Smiley has come up with a parts list for his mechanical hoists. Now he needs to find some place that's got this stuff in stock.
I'm gonna need 2 winches and 4 chain gears that actually pull the chain on this drawbridge that we're working on. Working on a show, Monster House. I'm actually on it. It's kind of weird. Jaw.
Steve's getting worried about Smiley's progress, or lack of it.
So as you can hear, we got a lot of work going on inside right now. 4 guys in there busting their butts and making a lot of progress, but I can't figure out Smiley. So far, the heaviest tools he's picked up is a catalog and a cell phone.
Hello? Hello?
Inside, he tries to stir up a little peer pressure.
I'm concerned that everything else is just cruising. All the bills are cruising, the construction's cruising. Everything's gonna be done, I think, by tomorrow and ready for these, all these mechanisms. And if those things don't work on Friday, then everyone sucks.
Oh, they'll work.
Everyone's screwed.
He'll just get there cranking like a monkey.
I just think maybe you guys wanna make sure you're all on the same page.
Sure.
Well, I better go check up on Smiley, see what he's up to.
The team tries to pin down their court jester.
Show me the pulleys and stuff.
No, pulleys are coming in, coming with the crank. Okay. All that stuff should be here this afternoon.
Cable's being delivered too?
Yep, that whole package should be coming this afternoon. And then the drawbridge. We've got Ryan up at Harbor Freight picking up 4 chain hoists. So while we're waiting for that, I'm gonna make a birdcage.
Right on.
You dig? I've been bouncing back and forth because it's like I got to talk to the same people.
Yeah, that's all right.
About, just, you know, 2 different projects. Yeah, sure, no, that's totally cool.
You got this under control.
He's got a bead on it.
All right, man, because I'm trusting you, man.
I got a magic wand in my toolkit, too. Everybody's checking up on me. Everybody's wondering what I'm doing. That's all right. Doesn't bug me.
Smiley takes his ear off the cell phone and puts his nose to the grindstone, cutting iron bars for his birdcage. Which brings up the story of how he got the name Smiley.
A while back, using one of those big 7/8 grinders, and it kicked back, and the whole thing came spinning around, and it kind of caught me right in the teeth right here. Caught me in this tooth, and it knocked this tooth over that way. So always wear your safety device.
By late afternoon, the plank doors for the laundry closet are built and ready to be hung. The hearth is framed out, and the hole is ready for its drawbridge. For the second day in a row, the confident crew decides to call it an early night.
See you guys in the morning.
By sundown, the only builder left is Smiley, who is holed up in the garage welding together his birdcage.
Damn, Smiley.
What's going on, man?
Well, I gotta tell you, that looks good.
Hey.
I thought you were gonna stay on the phone all day long, and now you're the last one here getting stuff done. I'm impressed.
All day long.
Day 3, and the last man out is the first man in. Smiley speeds up in a 73 BMW toaster tank. The rest of the crew isn't far behind, but instead of getting right to work, they linger over coffee and bagels. Then they kick off the day with a lot of clowning around.
Let me introduce you to my little friend.
Basically, what I've done is I've built myself into this corner.
Hey.
You know, that's not safe.
Even Smiley can't resist joining in the fun.
There's been some speculation this week about Smiley's real name. Me personally, I'm afraid to ask. I'm sure it's something like Bob or Bill. The other guys have sort of a running contest to see who can come up with his real name.
George. No, he's not a George. Marvin. I'd go with Marvin.
See that? That's the claw. That's the monster claw. Gah.
All right, let's do something.
By lunchtime, the midpoint of their build week, they've managed to accomplish almost nothing. Steve's starting to worry.
Day three's halfway over, and we are exactly halfway through the build week. I want to know what your ideas are and how much time you think we're going to have just in case something doesn't work.
Yeah, okay. I mean, we've got a couple of backup plans.
All I care about.
I think we're going pretty quick.
I think it's still too early to be overly confident.
Mm-hmm.
We've still got a lot of work to do.
I agree. I have a question. Are we going to sit here and talk, or are we going to go to work?
Get to work! This is the detail that goes on the bottom.
After lunch, Smiley heads back to his metal shop to put the final touches on his birdcage. For all his hard work, Smiley feels he deserves a pat on the back. Now that the birdcage is done, John can install the cables and cranks for lifting it up and down.
I've got the aircraft cable wired to the birdcage. This will go up, loop up on the pulley, come over and attach to our hand crank. This is the same hand crank that you'd find on high-end boat trailers.
A shipment of foam panels has arrived, and Chance starts transforming them into blocks of stone.
I'm gonna trim the entrance of here, the inside and the back, with a stone look. Block stones, different sizes, different depth. Just gonna make this thing 3D. You're just gonna feel like rock. And when it's done, painted, you won't know.
Apprentice Josh joins in.
Kind of excited for that. Something I've never done. I'm gonna learn a lot from it.
And you can kind of see how it starts giving it texturing. Some chips out like this. Take a corner out here, corner out there.
The sculpted styrofoam will still need to be sent out to be hardened and painted.
I'm impressed. It's
gonna be sweet.
Over by the hearth, Kurt adds cabinet doors for the home entertainment center.
Now the moment of truth. Oh.
And comes up a little short.
Oh, that hurts.
An embarrassing mistake, but nothing that can't be fixed.
It's a mistake. We all make them.
I don't know what he's talking about, man. They're perfect.
But first, Kurt needs to get started on another project, the frame for the barn doors.
There it is.
This time, his measurements are spot on. After a full day of sawdust and foam, the team takes a time out to help home builder Sid celebrate his birthday.
There you go. Happy birthday.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank
I
you.
Hope you wished for a finished house.
Get back to work. You guys should be working anyway. What is it?
There you are.
Aww. Thank you, though. I never celebrate my birthday. I grew up with seven brothers, so a birthday cake was few and far between, and this is by far the...
The best.
The most surprising and the best.
Ever.
So thank you very much.
Before calling it a night, they decide to put Smiley's birdcage to a test. Any volunteers?
That's the true test.
Is this gonna work?
Yep.
Be gentle.
It's time to bring down our entertainment for the evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Smiley can cross one item off his list. The guys have got a bounce in their step as they head home.
This is there's a little buzz out there about Smiley's ability, and yeah, he's gonna get it done. You know, he's got a lot of work ahead of him. He's got a lot of stuff going on, but right now he's in the shop, you know, doing what he does, and the expectations are really high now. So hopefully he can meet those things head on. We'll see.
It's day four. Sid and Roya are in no big hurry to move out of the RV.
Morning.
Morning. Welcome to the Monster House RV. This is the formal dining area.
That's right. Adjacent to the kitchen.
Where Sid does most of the cooking. It's Thursday now, and we're kind of at the midway point, and we just like having everybody around and kind of being the center of attention and having people stop by. And if you had to go an extra day, actually, that wouldn't be a problem.
I actually agree. It would be nice to...
We're gonna miss the Monster House crew.
Yeah.
Inside, the team has arrived, and Midnight Friday seems a lot closer than it did last night.
I'm starting not to be quite as confident as I was. There's a lot of to do, and we're running out of hours.
Yeah. Well, let's do this right here. Let's do this. This is gonna be our big list. All right, number one.
What's the biggest build that we think we can get finished today?
Hanging chain hoists and getting that thing running. Yep.
So, tables.
The next most biggest thing I see is the barn doors.
Barn doors.
Finish the hearth, the whole hearth.
Okay.
And what else am I forgetting?
Benches.
The benches. Yes, the benches.
And the bed of nails.
If we could get those four things done, that would leave us the bed of nails and the couch for tomorrow. I think we could do that.
That's the thing, we just gotta stay calm. As long as we're still cranking, I think we'll be fine.
Let's make it happen.
All right, let's get to work. Let's go. All right. Do this thing.
The pressure is on. The pressure is on.
John begins building benches for the family room. Kurt starts sawing lumber for the barn doors. Chance and Josh continue carving the foam stonework that will go around the doorways. And Smiley is only just getting started on the hoist for the drawbridge table. Now that the entire team is finally making some progress, the last thing they need is another distraction.
Welcome to Monster House, I'm Queen Elizabeth. The Monster House crew's inside turning this ugly house into a beautiful castle, fit for a queen. Oh, I can't wait. Well, I hear you have 2 days and you're just standing around.
Yeah.
It's not looking very much castle-like, is it?
That puppet didn't help at all.
I didn't even notice the puppet. I didn't know if that voice was coming out of that dude or not.
You could set your royal highness mm-hmm. right in it.
Yeah, watch it, boy.
And we could run you right up into the roof.
Queen's
done with it.
I love that, a royal throne. Yay! Well, on with it, on with it. Did you know that I'm the queen?
It's fairly obvious, isn't it?
Oh, boy, you're smart, aren't you? Did you pass first grade?
No, I did not.
Hello?
Hey, look, it's Queen Newt.
Oh,
it's a sock monkey.
Talk to me, sexy baby.
Come here, you little puppet.
Oh, fabulous.
It was nice meeting you, Queen.
Oh, thank you. Nice meeting you, too. Bye-bye. Ta-ta. Where's my carriage? Yoo-hoo, carriage. Taxi!
You know, there's a whole lot of puppets in this world, you know? Puppets that really expand puppetry as a medium and as an art form. And then there's puppets that help destroy that reputation.
Come on, tell me that you've never made love to a sock.
Dude, you're kind of weird, man. I'm busy.
Not even when you were a teenager or a truck driver.
I have no idea what you're talking about, man.
Chance and Josh have finished turning foam into stone. They sent it off for a process called hard coating, where the soft foam will be made to look and feel like rock. Their next challenge? Turning this simple wooden frame into a solid stone medieval hearth. The solution? Skins.
Just sit it right up against the wall for right now.
A mainstay of Hollywood set design, these lightweight molded sheets can be easily cut to fit. The hearth's wooden mantle calls for a 12-foot long solid oak beam. A real beam this size weighs over 1,600 pounds.
Got wood?
This one, molded out of foam, weighs about 50.
We're gonna put it up on the top, and then we're gonna... Are you all the way to the wall?
Oh, baby.
Sweet!
Get back and admire it.
That is a big beam.
Now with the rock, that's gonna look good. They're very happy. That's the rock wall that I'm gonna be cutting for the face of this and all through here. And I gotta piece it together like a puzzle.
That's good for there.
Whoa.
Kurt has one of the drawbridge tables finished and hanging in place.
Wait a minute, you did all the lifting. It's not that heavy.
Smiley hauls his still unfinished hoist inside to see if it's going to fit.
I guess. Oh my God. Yeah, sure.
The hinges holding the table weren't quite strong enough to hold Smiley.
Oh my God.
Sorry, Kurt. It seemed totally solid when I was standing on it.
Oh, he stood on it. That's what did it?
Yeah.
Did you fall?
Yeah.
Did you hurt?
No. I got some dust in my eye, though.
Because I'd rather seen you hurt than that hurt. Just a slight bit of frustration. Smiley better redeem himself with the mechanism, though.
It broke, and I was on it when it broke. Hey, better now than later, you know?
Steve invades Smiley's shop to give the table hinges some extra support should someone decide to stand on them again. But he's unprepared for Smiley's version of light conversation.
Of course, we all have our own personal jails. Jails of the mind, jails of the soul, jails of economic circumstances.
Damn, you got deep on me there for a second, Smiley. You kind of freaked me out.
Well, did you ever read No Exit by Sartre? Sartre drove a Dodge Dartura, you know. But he said that hell is other people, Steve.
Hell is other people?
Yeah.
You trying to tell me something? Smiley's a good worker when he's not talking.
Out front, the rocks for the archway have returned.
I'll just cut them and put them together. That's the stones I carved. They just got hard-coated.
Pretty tough stuff. At four? After. Nice and hard.
Well, here it is Thursday afternoon. I think all the guys now know that this is a huge job ahead of them. It's about time these guys start picking it up a little bit. They should have been this way on Tuesday. Right now we'd be having beers together, but instead we're here when the sun's going down and Smiley's having a hard time.
Creating a hoist for the drawbridge tables has Smiley stumped. The problem is coming up with one mechanism that can lower both tables independently. It also needs to be able to break so the tables don't just drop down. All this has got to fit inside a wall that's only 5 inches thick. To top it off, he has to fabricate it using tools designed for woodworking.
Yeah, it's just gonna break off.
At a loss, he calls a machinist friend for advice.
You see, we're using all the resources at our disposal, except for the right tools. It's been a real test of my mettle, so to speak.
You know, I'm really sweating this Smiley situation, these gears.
Because I got like 14 people leaning on me, like looking at me like, is he gonna f it up? So.
He can't seem to do what he's got going on back there. His idea's failing.
Well, you know what? You know what? I got things to do.
Showdown.
John knows that if Smiley fails, the team fails.
I can't imagine what he's done. You know, there's a whole lot of action going on here. I don't understand. Okay, does this one work?
Yeah.
And that one works.
Yeah.
Well, if you took this unit right here, just like it is, don't change a thing, then you just weld the frickin' gear in sync with this gear.
You're right.
But.
Yeah.
That's too easy.
And there's always a big but, right?
I'm starting to actually right now to wonder if they're gonna get it done by tomorrow night.
Out front, even our unsuspecting homeowners are getting nervous.
Now, if we go in and I really hate it, do I just hide that and smile fake?
No, we want your real emotion. Absolutely. We want to know exactly how you feel about it. Otherwise, it's not worth us in there killing ourselves like.
Yeah, Roy's not too good at hiding emotion.
I want to see the real thing.
Could I just peek now and?
No, but enjoy the RV a couple more nights. I'll see you guys later.
The sun is going down, and so far, not one major project has been crossed off the to-do list.
It's all still there.
Chance and Josh are still adding masonry to the stone hearth. Kurt is still sawing lumber for the barn doors, and the drawbridge tables are in a holding pattern until Smiley gets the hoist installed.
This is fun, isn't it?
Got it.
I don't think anything, man. I'm just gonna see.
So John turns up the pressure on our mad monk of metal, and Smiley is starting to crack.
I don't know what to make of this guy, if he's a real bozo or if he's just some kind of a mechanical genius.
At just after 9, John decides to give up and go home. Smiley's still stumped. But at least now, nobody's breathing down his neck. At just before midnight, he takes his hoist inside for a fitting. And Smiley's not smiling. It's the final day of our feudal makeover. True to form, Smiley is the first to arrive. But all these late nights are starting to show. Sid and Roya emerge from the RV and come face to face with a dragon.
So awesome.
I think peculiar thoughts of Smiley's car.
How did we know it was Smiley's car?
Smiley knows what he's doing. I have no doubts about Smiley.
The other team members dribble in and start working. Last night, they left without completing a single project. To finish by midnight tonight, they're going to have to go into overdrive. And already there's a problem. The only man who can finish the foam and skin exteriors on the Hearth Entertainment Center hasn't shown up for work.
He said he was just getting out of bed.
Must be nice that you can just come in late.
The good news is that Smiley's finally ready to give his drawbridge hoist its trial run.
Remember, no stepping on the table. There we go.
Skeptical John connects the chains to the tables and gives it a go. It works.
No, you're not.
I'm gonna kiss you right now.
Hey, right on, bro.
I think that's great. I think it's great. I want to kiss him, but he won't kiss me.
And old King Smiley does a little rejoicing. Over at the barn doors, Kurt's working his own brand of magic.
Dude, this is bitchin'. Oh, yeah!
Hello.
Check that out.
It's really hard being this good and looking this good.
We know, yeah, go back to work, go back to work. Got a lot to do.
Midnight today.
Steve is pleased to see some progress when, hold it, is that Chance trying to sneak in? Yes, it is.
A few hours
and
left.
He's 4 hours late.
Chance.
But this tardy builder has got the monster house excuse of the week.
I got a bad back. I broke my back about 10 years ago and was paralyzed. So it flares out once in a while when I push myself pretty hard, you know. And I went off a cliff in a car and rolled 7 times up and fell into a river upside down. And I fractured and I was paralyzed from the neck down. And they said I'd never walk. And I kind of had a near-death experience, and it took me 3.5 years to recover. But sometimes when I'm working, I get a little carried away and forget that I had the injury, and I pay for it, you know.
Bad back or not, Chance doesn't want to let the team down. He and Josh attached the last of the stone skins using a quick-drying spray-on adhesive.
Then all of a sudden, he starts spraying. He just shot me straight in the eye. It's too bad it didn't foam up, because when it foams up with that spray, it'll foam up in your eye, and it crusts up, and it actually falls out, so it's better. But really, it's just some chemicals. Now it's just going to be an eye irritation.
Joshua heads off for the hospital, and the team is suddenly one man down. The sun is setting, and our struggling builders have still got a long way to go. Chance now has to finish the hearth on his own. Kurt has to attach the foam beams to the ceiling. John needs to finish the housing for the drawbridge hoist. Smiley is back in his metal shop working on a crank handle for the TV lift. With only 4 hours left, it's going to be close.
Here's what's happening right now. It is Friday night. We have less than 4 hours left. I have four builders, one with a bad back, which leaves you about 3.5 builders. One's in the hospital. There you go. Monster House, Friday night.
Inside, the cliches start flying.
About the middle of the third quarter, they're down by 25, and that's exactly how I feel.
It's a real horse race. It's a full court press. We'll take it to the wire.
It's a balls to the wall time here at Monster House, Friday night. Right now, we have just over an hour left, like an hour and 15 minutes left.
Just when they need him most, Josh returns and dives into a bed of nails.
Right now, I'm working on a coffee table for their living room.
Josh has been hitting on doctors and nurses at the hospital.
No, it's not true.
If you've got enough in you to flirt with a nurse, you can come back here and finish the job.
So I'm back full force for another hour. Let's wrap this up by midnight.
43 minutes.
Get that guy out there.
Let's go. Come on. What are you doing? 40 minutes. 39 minutes.
Yeah, why don't you go check on somebody else? Tell them how much time we got left.
We have about 39 minutes left. Think we're gonna make it?
Make what?
35 minutes left.
It is ticking awful quick.
Yeah. No, that looks great, though. That looks great.
We didn't have any black paint, so I pretty much painted it, stained it.
How did you get the black?
Hey, that's coffee with a little black tint they had in there, but mostly just, yeah, coffee.
You know, come on, it's a coffee table.
That's Monster House.
With 15 minutes to go, the hearth is still missing a crank. But Sir Smiley rides in to the rescue.
Hey, I want to kiss you, man. If you weren't so damn dirty, I would kiss you.
We are 10 minutes away from midnight. Guys are moving like crazy.
It's a mad dash to midnight when the bell finally tolls.
It's midnight, Joshua. Come on up. Guys, it's midnight. That's it. Come on.
Okay, I'm coming. I'm coming. It's good. I'm all good now, bud.
Our noble knights pursued their quest until the last tick of the clock. But did they get it done? Steve goes down the list.
So we know the couch is done. So the couch is off our list. The bed of nails, the coffee table is done. The drawbridge table and the hearth. I mean, it's obvious, you take a look at it. From what I can tell, it's all done. You guys had a great week. Congratulations. You guys are awesome. Monster Builder.
To get this castle ready for our homeowners, designer Tara Stevenson and her monster finishing crew add the final touches.
Fine tuning and detail work. That's what today is all about. Just trying to make it look nice and pretty and homey in a medieval sort of way.
Including wall treatments from Mioded, paints and decorations and home furnishings from IKEA.
My hope is that when they walk in, they love the way it looks, but they also feel like they can move right in.
Finally, the time has come for Sid and Roya to get their first look at what we've done to their home.
Been a long week in the RV. You ready to check this thing out?
Yes, right.
I think so.
Let's go see your new monster house.
All right. You ready? You want to go okay?
Saturday. After 5 days exiled in the motorhome, Sid is just itching to see his medieval manor.
There's the big man himself.
How are you?
Hey, Steve.
Roya, however, looks a little nervous.
It's trembling just a bit. I don't know if I can do this.
Take a deep breath.
So.
Let's go see your new monster house.
All right. You ready? You want to go okay?
Welcome to your monster house.
Oh my god.
Wow. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
That's,
So what are you thinking? What are you thinking?
Wow. It's very authentic.
I have something I would like to show you here.
It's also your new dinner table.
Authentic drawbridge, medieval times. Spanish cedar top. Raise and lower from over here, and you can raise and lower this side from over there.
That's amazing.
It's very, really spot on.
Yeah, it's actually spot on. Yeah, it really is.
Do you like it so far?
I love it.
It's beyond what we imagined.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
So what is the first thing that you noticed when you came in? What's the first thing that blew you away?
These the rafters.
The beams?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Isn't that great?
That's fantastic.
It's much cozier.
Yeah.
It's very warm.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is. It's a lot warmer than it was.
Are you ready for some more?
There's more.
Oh. Are you ready for more?
You thought this was it? You thought, well, this is Monster House, not Monster Room. Your new living room? Come on in. This is your house. Come on in here. Dead center. Take it all in.
This isn't the same house.
Like the handcuffs, that's a very subtle but noticed.
Those are just a prop. Just to stay on the table. You
know? We'll be the judge of that.
Yeah, yeah.
This is Kurt. He's going to show you a couple of things.
No monster house is complete without a couple of stable doors for the horses. There you go.
All right, so this is Chance, and he's going to show you a little bit about your medieval hearth.
I did all the stone and most of this big old heavy beam. I had to turn it on my back here. We got cabinets over here for you. These open up. Boom. Boom. Right in there. Even, let's see. What else? Am I missing something?
You got to update the hearth.
You gotta update time. Yes. Well, we figured we won't destroy your TV, so we put something like this in there.
Oh, God. Yeah. You're safe, honey. You're safe. That's awesome.
For being patient and staying in an RV for 7 days, you've got a surround sound system throughout your house from our friends at Just In Time Communications.
I am completely blown away because I've actually been in a castle and I know that sort of, because there's an ambience to it. Mm-hmm. That's sort of really hard to replicate and I'm in a castle.
This is beyond what we could anticipate, honestly.
We have one more thing to show you.
Okay.
Since now you're a royal family in your castle, you have to have your royal portrait.
Oh, Jesus.
Is there anything about this house that you would change? Are you going to keep it besides that? Now that we've shown you everything in your house, and it's time for a good old-fashioned medieval feast.
First of all, I think I'd like to commend you, all of you, on a job really well done. And to whoever said Rome wasn't built in a day, I say you haven't met the Monster House crew.
Yeah.
Right.
Guys, I think you've earned it. I think it's time to feast.
Right on.
Right on.
I say all hell to the builders.
Yeah.
All right, guys, here we are. It was a long week. You guys all did a great job. We all kicked ass this week. I'm honored to be giving you your prizes today. It's time for the prizes. You got a 18-volt cordless combo kit from Makita. You got a Makita 10-inch dual-slide miter saw. And you got the ESAB Presto Light Master Outfit with tanks right here. Because I know you wanted to start working with some metal, so there you go. All right, guys, congratulations. They belong to you.
Awesome.
It was awesome.
Until next time, when who knows, the monster may be coming to your house.
Make way for the king and his knights so brave, for they have returned to the castle.